Hi, I'm Joanne Chase. I teach English at West Lincoln High School, and I teach the best students in the world, and this is me.
Beyond the numbers, scores, grades, and wins and losses, Lincoln County Schools desires to showcase real people, local families, real struggles, successes, and real stories that are part of our own untold story. This is a great place to work, learn, play, and grow, and we want our community to see the strength from our own. We are hashtag LCS strong to the core. Ms. Chase, thanks for being a part of our conversation about strength and what it means to be strong. And Mr. Cleary, when I ask about who signifies strength and courage at West Lincoln High School, you were his go-to answer. So why do you think that is? What happened in your life that made you strong?
I would say probably the biggest thing that's happened in my life that's made me strong is my journey through cancer and the battle to become healthy again.
What kind of cancer did you have?
I had breast cancer and was diagnosed in January of 2016, just a few days before my birthday.
Wow. And you end up having a double mastectomy?
Yes, I had a bilateral mastectomy. I chose to do both breasts because I felt like I had cancer in one breast. One side tried to kill me, the other side won't do. And I didn't want to ever have to go back there again.
Got it. You know, with cancer and all sorts of cancers that are out there, and breast cancer is the one you had, and I'll call it the opportunity to endure, because cancer changes everybody differently. How has cancer changed you as a teacher and as a wife?
As a wife, I've always felt like I had the best husband in the whole world, but this just proved it to me. I was so sick many, many days and couldn't even get out of bed and just would sleep through the morning. And my husband, I would wake up and there would be a cup with coffee and crackers. Mm. It was like he knew what I needed that day. Mm. He just knew it. And as a teacher, it helps me understand better what some of our kids are going through, that you don't realize what's going on at home.
Got it.
And so you gotta always keep in the back of your mind, this person may not be feeling well today.
And so in your role as a teacher, since your bout with cancer in 16, you've taken on a leadership role here at West Lincoln High School, and you are the captain of the Relay for Life team.
Yes, sir.
Talk about your experience in that role with kids here, but also with the Relay for Life movement.
Mr. Cleary had asked me if I would do that when I came, and I was just out of treatment when I first came. I finished my last treatment on July the 1st of 2016 and then started here August of 2016. And so I was still bald.
Yeah.
The kids just rallied. They just were like, we'll help, we'll help. And it was great. I had students that came up with design for the t-shirt and they started getting excited about wanting to help. And every year I'd think, oh gosh, what am I gonna do without this student or that student because they're graduating, and somebody else just steps up.
What does it mean for you with Relay for Life and the survivor walk and the whole awareness that they bring about? Talk about your experience on your first survivor walk.
My first survivor walk was the hardest walk I've ever done. I was still in chemo, and the first walk I did was at the Catawba County Fairgrounds, and they asked you to tell your name and how long a survivor you were. And I was standing there listening to people saying, you know, and I'd hear breast cancer 18 years, and I think, yes, I can do this, I can do this. And all of a sudden it was my turn, and I had to say my name. And I said my name, and it was like I had to take a deep breath because I had to say, I'm still fighting. Mm. And I could just feel fighting the tears from that because I was still in chemo. And I could barely make it around the track. And just about the time I thought, I can't make it, go get a wheelchair for me, somebody from the sidelines called my name, and it was Linda Richards. And she called my name, and I saw her, and you know, that her energy, it was like I absorbed her energy, and it gave me a little bit more energy. And the cheerleaders came up behind me, and you can do this, and everybody was, you can do this, you can do this. They knew I was getting ready to falter, and I made it through. I was exhausted, but I made it through, and my husband was with me every step of the way.
So you mentioned, you know, you came here in August of 16. You came from another school system, came to West High, but you kind of changed roles in the middle of this. So you had your people in Catawba County and then people now in Lincoln County that are supporting you through your journey. Now's your time to kind of say anything to those people. What do you want to say?
Oh, wow. I had people like Billy Cannon at Newton Conover High School, and I had Brenda Schreiber. I had people that were just so supportive of me, and people would just send me messages that said they were praying for me. And I was to the point where I couldn't pray for myself, but knowing other people were praying for me, I just felt like everything was going to be all right. And the support, I just can't tell you. First person that came to me at this school was Tammy Johnson, our library person, our media center coordinator, and she was the first person to come to me and say, "You're going to make it through this. You're going to make it through it." I can't tell you about the support. I can't to start naming people. I know I'd miss somebody's name.
And when you're in it, sometimes you can't see that I am going to make it, or I'm going to be able to finish this lap, or finish this day, or finish this week. So your words now are doing that for other people through this video.
Yes.
But Joanne, talk about, why do you think Mr. Cleary saw strength in you? Do you think you're strong?
I know I'm strong. I've done a lot of things in my life that I've had to be strong. And like I said, cancer's the hardest one ever. When I came here, I could barely make it from my parking place out front to the front to my classroom. I could barely make it. I was exhausted. Just getting into work. And I had a team teacher with me for one of my classes, and that was Rick Mitchum. And if you know Rick's tall, bald-headed, and here I was, short, fat, bald-headed. And I told kids, I said, you know, it's going to be hard for you to know which one is which. You know, Mitchum's tall, Chase is short, fat, bald-headed, that's both bald. And he was such a support. He was like, he was so afraid, how's she going to do this? And he was a big support for me. Let me run, go do that for you. Let me, you know.
Yeah.
And then in the classroom, he was present and always letting me know it was okay. So I had other teachers that kind of let me know it was okay. And every day, I would make myself walk to the office from my classroom and back and walk. And then I got stronger and I'd start walking a little further. And I just kept walking. And before cancer, I was walking a couple miles a day, every day, after my first treatment, I couldn't walk a quarter of a mile.
Wow. Well, Ms. Chase, you definitely have given inspiration to people. You've got a good story about perseverance, about keeping at it, even when you don't want to do it.
Yeah, you got it.
You have to, that's right. You have to keep fighting. And I appreciate you showing us how strong you really are. And telling us your story.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for letting me share a small part of my story. I'm proud to be part of #LCS Strong to the Core.